Alright, so now we have to infiltrate the castle itself.
Hmm.
You can tell there's many enemies because the loading screen is longer.
Yeah. Well, I half lied. We're not in the castle itself just yet, but we will be soon.
Well, I mean, it's the castle square.
You said we were in the castle, but we're not in the castle.
Technically the castle surrounds this entire area, so we're in the castle, Ryan.
No.
Castles typically protect entire towns, Ryan.
Christmas is cancelled.
No, I'm saying we're not truly in the castle until we're actually in the castle part.
But we are in the castle part. You see the castle wall right there?
No, the actual building part that's the castle.
Excuse you, but are we not surrounded by the building?
No, I mean like the actual main part.
Yeah, yeah.
You're so picky.
If we were in Honnoji, I would want us to be in Nobunaga's bedroom.
You'd want to be in Nobunaga's bedroom for a bunch of other reasons.
Maybe, but
can't,
you know what?
Can't blame.
Right. I love my Japanese Dracula.
Yep. Alright, maybe this cow will help. No, Al, you get fucking Al! What?
That cow will destroy.
God damn it, Al.
It's so vicious, it won't stop. It keeps going.
I don't think you need the red loincloth anymore.
And this guy is still just hanging out over here.
He survived the cow. I think he deserves.
No. Hey, buddy, follow me. There we go. And he dropped an item.
Al, we found your new vehicle.
Yep.
Ow! Okay. It's too bad there isn't anything else here. And you can drive it inside.
I know, right? That would be lovely.
Just drive through the door, knocking down the door.
I mean, that would make what's coming up a bit easier, right? I would think, but... whatever. Here, you're gonna want to make a wind weapon. Believe me, you want to. Now that all these enemies are gone. So now we just wait for that cow to run out so I can collect the elixir off it.
Because you totally... Thank you! Because you're not, like, maxed out already.
Hey, you can never be too careful.
You can never have enough things above the item limit.
Mm-hmm. I'm just checking to make sure I didn't miss anything. Okay, yeah, nothing. So, let's go collect that cow.
Gonna make yourself some good hamburgers.
Get in here. We're now in the castle foyer.
Now we're in the real castle.
If you say.
Oh god, this looks like the entrance from Resident Evil 1.
I know, right?
You were almost an alchemy sandwich.
Speaking of that.
Oh, Lord.
It's all coming back to you, isn't it, Ryan?
Yeah.
Yep, this is Jens. He is the most annoying boss in this whole game. How did he live through that, is my question. Jesus Christ.
And how much of him is actually, you know, left?
Probably just his brain. So yeah, here's Gens in his full metal mode. You want to know what the gimmick of this guy is now?
Mm-hmm.
No matter...
He does not...
Go on.
He does not get damaged by anything other than explosives?
No, he doesn't get damaged by anything, period. Basically, his gimmick is that no matter what you do to him, he will always take 1 point of damage. This makes for an incredibly tedious fight, and also why Wind Element is your best friend here. That's the only way to speed things up.
That's a terrible idea.
Mm-hmm. I think you can do a little bit more damage to him if you do nothing but stack your attack stat throughout the whole game, but I'm not entirely sure on that. This guy is also the reason I've been doing nothing but stacking defense and HP, because at this point it just becomes a battle of who can live longer.
And I mean, you also are the one to only take 1 point of damage.
Exactly. Also, to add insult to injury, this guy's boss music is really boring. Yeah, it's nice. I'll be over here. So, yeah. The only advice I can really give to you is just have your wind dagger on hand and just repeatedly stab him. That's the best I've got.
Ow.
I don't know either. Here, Al, you take it. Let's see if I can lure Gens up here. Seeing as he followed me last time, you know. Hey, Gens. Hey, buddy. Gonna jump up here?
You're not making it easy for him.
gonna get up here, hey?
Dude. He's under the thing.
Dude.
You can see him on the map.
Is he literally just gonna stand there and wait?
It's like, where is he?
I mean, dude. Technically, he's right next to you.
Bro. Hello. Oh, he's gonna come up. No.
What?
Alright, asshole, fine. Fine. We'll come to him. He's gonna be a bitch. Come on, Alphonse.
His AI does not comprehend the idea of, the multi-layered map.
Mm-hmm. Alright, let's do it. And since his boss fight is boring and his music is boring, I decided I'm gonna speed things up and put my own music in.
Thank God for 4x speed.
Mm-hmm. I wish it could go faster, considering how stupid the fight is.
10x speed is what you were probably looking for.
Right.
That would actually take my rendering the video quite a bit.
Yeah. If you're curious, this song is from Phoenix Wright. It's Cross-Examine Allegro. First game. So yeah, Gens just kind of jumps around, throws fireballs. Occasionally, he'll summon these metal spike things or try to punch you. The only real advice, again, I can give is just kind of swerve around him and take pot shots at him when you can.
Oh god. It's like one of those bosses which is like, at the very least, he doesn't heal.
Thank God.
That would make this just the most impossible thing.
If he healed himself, I would quit this game.
What if after you?
Then it would go like full Odin sphere, and you never go full Odin sphere.
Yeah.
It's like after get all his HP down, he brings it back up again.
Oh, and by the way, whenever he face plants on the ground, don't be near him, because that means he's gonna summon those spikes and they will basically auto-kill you. Yeah. As they do with Alphonse.
Well, at the very least, here you have His death doesn't matter. But now here at the very least you have multiple weapons and whatnot.
Yeah.
Be happy I didn't make you sit that.
Complete time, 12 minutes and 25 seconds.
Yep. Yeah, I mean, there's not even any music, Al. What are you talking about? I don't hear that smell. Finally, the space mice are done eating.
I was about to start beatboxing.
That was a very weird watch sound. Because it was one of the most intense clocks I have ever heard.
Yes.
Just like socks.
Mm-hmm. If only AJ were here, I'd make him meow.
Take it out of context.
Yeah.
even in the context. Nah, well. It's not better in the context either.
Mm-hmm. Thank God they give you a save point right after. Alright.
And you never have to do it again.
Time to see the stupid architecture of this castle. We're now in the center corridor. Now, despite the fact that we prevented the military from getting in here, there's gonna be military goons in here. Oh, how to assign my bonus points.
Put them all in strength.
Oh. We're just gonna keep doing vitality and defense, because enemies hurt in this part of the game. So, yeah.
But you're taking one damage anyway.
Doesn't matter. Still stacking.
Like, do you want them to start healing you instead of doing damage?
I wish that were possible. That would be amazing. Like, my defense just gets so high they do negative damage.
Or it, like, does the... the other way around. It does the whole civilization thing. Where your defense is so high, like as high as it can possibly be, and then you increase it one more time, and it gets over time, so it gets to the lowest point possible.
Yes.
Because like in civilization, there is this whole thing where we have Gandhi, and he is the most peaceful person possible. But
because
then
of that,
if you
it rolls
do...
over and he's the most violent person possible.
Yes. And they actually kept it in the future games.
Good.
Like, they actually made him, like, super aggressive right off the bat. It's the same principle as that glitch from Wild Arms 1.
Yeah.
Which I actually checked, it doesn't work in the remake, sadly.
That's dumb.
It's even funnier because they actually made the interface for the items very similar to how it was in 1. However, they do, and you can actually replace an item that you've used, but it does keep track of what the item you used was.
Aww. So, eh. Just get 255 apples.
Or like what I did, 255 duplicators, and never have to worry about it again. It's like, oh, there is one of those in this one town, and there is one of those in this other town on the other side of the world. I wonder what they could be used for. I got one duplicated 255 times. Never need to worry about it. Didn't even go to that other town. Oh, the wind dagger is so good.
Indeed. That said, I'm technically being wasteful here. After the Gens fight, you're going to want to continue to save your wind element. In fact, depending on how much you have, start using whichever you have the most of. In my case, I had lightning. But I decided I wanted to be unique and give all the elements a final show off, so I used fire a couple times here as well.
Is that guy seriously fighting you with a beer case?
Yeah. Got a problem with briefcases, Ryan?
Well, I mean, if he's planning on going on
vacation,
have
you ever been hit in the head with a briefcase, Ryan?
I'm sure it would hurt. However, there are several other things that would probably hurt more.
Ryan,
like this cow.
Ryan, I think you're being racist against briefcases. Just saying.
Do you want me to quote "The suffering ties that bind" again? You gotta wash away all the losers.
Suffering 2 was not all that great.
I only played the demo of the one game I am referring to, but that one line is like there when there's like the scared guy that you have a choice to either shoot or apparently save. I don't know how you're supposed to save him.
Yeah, first suffering was good, the second one is just stupid and impossible.
Oh, Al, you're so adorable on your freaking...
He is so happy to try.
He is.
Back and forth.
Brother, look. I'm a real tank now.
whatever. So... if you're wondering where that door leads, the one that was on the left there, it just leads back to the castle foyer, so ignore it. So we're going to walk back and go through a different door we passed up.
Okay, so far I'm kind of keeping up with the architecture of this place.
So yeah, there's where we came in. There is nothing hidden this way, so into this door. Now we're in West Hall 1. Oh look, more people to beat up. Let's do that.
That girl has a weird arm.
She has two automail arms, Ryan.
One's weird and one's okay.
Ryan, why do you hate everything that's different?
I don't. That was just... it was either that or a masturbation joke. Because that's a pretty big hand.
But, well... if that's the case, why is the left one the weird one?
I don't know, maybe she's good with that
no
hand.
Prob. No prob! No prob!
Oh, thank God I'm out. Jesus Christ.
But it was no problem. It was no problem. You should replace one of those no problems with Farah's no problem.
Oh god. No. I'll just make it even worse for me.
No problem.
No problem.
No problem.
Problem.
Big problem.
There's a big problem.
Oh, what to do? I have so many resources at my hand.
Yeah, you have like over 99 of those elixirs S's.
I don't know what you're talking about, sir.
Some people might say you're an alchemist.
They should make a FMA HD collection with all three games.
Oh, that'd be cool. And what if they actually officially translated the third one?
That'd be nice.
Get the voice actors to do it. Although, Al will obviously be different.
Get the voice actors from... PAL version of Okage to do the voice work. Thank you.
I heard they're really cheap.
Well, yeah, I mean if they wanted to save on money, yeah.
Well, I mean,
probably.
obviously they're cheap, they're hired by a restaurant chain to do voice acting for an RPG from 15 years ago.
Weird that they did that for a PS4 game, you know?
Yeah, that's really odd.